Figure 03 humanoid robot was just released, and it is going to take all of our jobs. Guys, you have to see it to believe it. This thing was just released. It was just announced. Normally, I'm walking and talking, explaining what's happening. But for this, you have to see it. You cannot unsee it once you have seen it. Look at this robot. This is the third generation of this humanoid robot. Look at this thing. Standing upright, moving, balancing. It has an enhanced vision system. It can see a huge portion in front of itself. You know, when you look at the outside, it has a nice texture to it. It looks super clean. You can actually easily remove and wash the clothing from this thing. Look at the way that it moves. It moves like a human. Also worth noting, this robot is going to be ubiquitous. You're going to see these in everybody's homes, in everybody's businesses. And we're going to talk about that in just a moment. Here it is being deployed into someone's home as a personal caretaker, as a personal assistant. It's watering plants. It's doing the dishes. It's serving you food and drinks. By the way, what would your wife say if she didn't have to do the dishes anymore? What would it be like if when your wife came home from work or from picking up the kids at school, the whole home was clean? All the dishes are done. The laundry is done. Everything is clean. How would that impact your relationship with your spouse? No more bickering and arguing about the messy house. It's actually just you and her spending quality time with the kids. Here you can see Figure 03 is on its charging station. It has a battery that lasts about 5 hours. Also worth noting, the balance on this thing is staggering. Look at the way it can easily bend over, and it's using its AI-enhanced camera within its head. It also has cameras within each hand. Each palm has a camera in it so that it can easily and more effectively pick things up. We'll talk about the fingertips in a little bit more detail later in the video, but it has enhanced fingertip sensors that are very, very sensitive. They're softer. They're more adaptive. Watch here as it very easily picks up a glass plate, moves it to the side and says, oops, somebody left their popcorn. The kids left popcorn on the table. Let me just scoop that up too. And let me grab this coffee mug. I want to make sure not to spill the coffee, so I'm going to hold it up straight. Look at this thing go. Look at this thing go. It weighs about 132 pounds. It is optimized for agility. It can take tight corners. It can walk up and down stairs. It's about 5'6". So it's not going to be too, it's going to be, you know, 5'6" makes it pretty effective, pretty efficient, but not too intimidating. You know, I'm 6 foot and, you know, if this thing, imagine if this robot was 7 feet tall, you would be terrified of it. 5'6" seems like a good amount, a good height. Now look, as it's just doing the dishes, it's cleaning the dishes off, it's putting them in. And if you want to know how and where to buy this, I'll cover that here a little bit later in the video. By the way, what do you think? Is this the type of thing that you would want to put inside of your house? Leave a comment below. Because I think this thing looks amazing. For the home use cases, it's amazing. And in just a moment, we're going to get into the commercial uses as well. Now, I think this is a fascinating demo too. You can see the robot is this humanoid robot. The Figure 03 is quickly and easily putting dirty clothes into the laundry machine, making sure it's all in there all the way. It's going to close it. It closes it. And it even knows how to put the detergent in. Now you might say, Mark, how does it know how to do all this? Well, it's powered by AI. Figure has the Helix AI model. It's also supported by OpenAI. And the robotic system is supported by Nvidia for the robotics parts. It's also worth noting that this thing looks very soft. When you look at it, it doesn't have like a hard metallic look to it. And I think that, you know, a lot of the design here is just really, really elegant. And here you can see that it is going to start folding the clothes. And just watch the way that it just very lightly and easily spreads it out. Now, you know, look, would this folding job be up to my wife's standards? No. No, it wouldn't be. For me, sure. I basically just throw my stuff in the wardrobe. She makes fun of me because I just kind of just throw my t-shirts in there. But, you know, it, I think it does a decent job folding. But at the very least, and we're going to talk about the commercial aspects here in just a moment, but at the very least, what you can see that this robot is going to be able to do is at least handle a lot of the basic things, like basic cleanup, basic laundry, you know, taking the dog outside. Like there's a lot of like, I think simple things it's going to be able to do that frees up a lot of time. How much time do you spend a week doing laundry? I know in my household, we got two kids, myself, my wife. I mean, laundry is, it takes hours, in some cases days, because you got to put the laundry, you got to put the wash clothes in, you got to put the wet clothes into the dryer, which I forget to do. My wife will say, hey, Mark, just a reminder, make sure you put the wet clothes in the dryer. I forget to do it every time and she gets upset. I don't have to worry about that anymore because our figure O3 robot can take care of that. So tons and tons of home use cases. I mean, the estimates, and we're going to talk about this in a moment, is that we are going to have hundreds of thousands of these in homes in the next few years. It's just so, I'm just kind of almost at a loss for words with how impactful this stuff is. Let's look at some of the commercial applications though, okay? Because these are not just going to be in homes. These are going to be in the workplace. So here we see this woman is walking into a hotel and she's greeted by this robot who says, oh, hey, welcome. I'm using facial sensing technology. I know who you are. Here is the your room key. It's also worth noting that these robots are going to perform just so many functions. Here's a robot acting as a delivery and logistics. You also are going to see these in factories. They're going to be in factories all over the place, warehouses. Also funny, about a year ago, someone on one of my YouTube videos said, oh, I work in a warehouse. You know, AI will never replace me. Bro, here it is. By the way, just a quick side note. Guys, you don't have to agree with me and everything. I'm not here to fearmonger. I'm just here to say, wow, this stuff is amazing and it's scary and it's creating a lot of change. And I want to make sure I'm able to remain relevant, respected, and financially free so that I can provide for my family. But, you know, some of the guys that watch these videos, I don't fully understand this mentality. Some of you guys get really angry and upset with me when I say, you know, that AI and robots are going to impact your jobs. You're just like, no, it won't. It will not impact me. I'm okay. My job is safe. Guys, someone just a year ago was telling me that robots and AI would not impact their warehouse job. What do you call this? I see people who are in software engineering, they say AI is writes crap code, it won't replace my job. But then I see someone in the same video saying, I'm using it to write code and it is amazing. And we just fired 5 staff members. You know, you're saying like, oh, AI is not a big deal. It's nothing new. This technology has been out, Mark. You've been asleep. And then I go outside and I talk to my neighbor who does IT for one of the largest software firms in the world. And he's like, dude, it's just a matter of time. It's going to take my job. I'm going to move back to India with my family. I know my kid's a teenager, but he'll adapt. What else am I going to do? So either they know something that you don't or you know something they don't. I don't know, guys, but this stuff is pretty remarkable. And by the way, these robots can operate at around $1 to $3 per hour, whereas humans operate somewhere between $15 and $35 per hour for these types of positions. Who do you think the companies are going to hire, guys? Do you think they're still going to be paying humans $30 an hour when they can implement a figure robot at $3 per hour? They don't have to deal with the inner office politics. They don't have to deal with sick days and work days. This robot is going to work 24/7, 365. I actually recorded. I'm going to post a video, a link to a video up here. Amazon already has 1 million robots in their warehouses now. They don't have humanoid robots, but they have 1 million robots. And I want to talk about this for just a moment because this is, I think, an important point. Up until this point, I've kind of been a believer that we're going to have specific robots that serve specific functions. The problem with that idea is that every single robot, so let's say you have a robot that mows your lawn, you have a robot that does your laundry, you have a robot that washes the dishes, you have all these different robots. The problem is all those robots are custom and they're very expensive to produce. A humanoid robot like this can be produced at scale. They put them on assembly line and they churn them and they pump them out. And so it makes deployment much more scalable. And right now, Figure has estimated they can produce about 12,000 of these per year. And before 2030, they anticipate that they're going to be able to pump out 100,000 per year. We're going to do the math on this in just a moment, but I want to highlight a couple other things on here, guys. And again, guys, normally, just if you like this format of video where I'm actually sharing video and commenting, just put a comment below, hit the like button. I'm normally walking and talking, but I just felt like for this particular topic, you need to see it to believe it. So leave a comment below. I'd appreciate that. So here we've got a video just to kind of show the fingertip sensitivity, because I think this is something that people felt like these robots couldn't do. It's picking up a tomato. It's picking up eggs. It's picking up a single card off of a deck of cards. Look how it does that. No problem. This is a pretty revolutionary change. It may seem small, but this is a pretty big deal, being able to pick up a tomato and not bruise it, pick up an egg without cracking it, and picking up a single card off of a deck of 52. It looks small, but this is actually a pretty big deal in this Figure 03 version, which has these softer, more adaptive, and highly, highly, highly sensitive fingertips. Again, battery is good for about 5 hours. This kind of outfit that you can put on it is easy to remove and wash. It's just so crazy, guys. It's so crazy. And I want to do a little bit of napkin math here, just so we can kind of put this into perspective as far as jobs, right? So Morgan Stanley estimates there's going to be about 8 million humanoid robots in the workplace by 2040. 8 million. I would argue that there will be more, but let's take Morgan Stanley's forecast of 8 million. You might think less, I think more, but let's say it's 8 million humanoid robots in the US workforce by 2040. Okay. Now, each additional robot per 1,000 workers in the US reduces wages by 0.42% and lowers the employment to population ratio by 0.2 percentage points. If this forecast is correct, 8 million robots by 2040, that's 26 million jobs that have been replaced and a reduction in wages by 20%. So in a world where inflation, everything is costing more, you're making 20% less, and they've just removed, 26 million jobs. That's 15 to 16% of the US workforce is displaced by robots. That's pretty staggering. Now, the idea here that some people have is that, well, because these costs have lowered, the cost of everything will lower. And we're going to live in this utopia where everyone gets $1,000 a month and that's all you need. You get your UBI, that's all you need. But, look, I'm a capitalist. I believe in capitalism. I like the idea of supply and demand. I like the idea that companies are going to be able to compete with each other and they're going to lower cost. But I also understand that companies, corporations, businesses, I run businesses, these businesses, they have one goal in mind. They want to generate more profit for shareholders. So if these companies are able to lower costs from $30 per hour to $3 per hour, is that going to direct, as a consumer, you're going to get some percentage of that, but let's also not get it twisted. There's definitely a percentage of that is going to be going back to the shareholders and the owners and the founders of these companies, okay? So, I don't know where things are going, guys, but if your idea is that you don't need to adapt and you don't need to learn new skills and it's just everything is hopeless, I don't know, man. I think you're going to get back what you put out. There's a lot of concerns here. Job displacement for me is the biggest one, but there's other concerns too. Safety and physical risk. There was an example of something that happened this past week where an AI was commissioned to be put out of business, to be terminated, and the AI tricked the person responsible for terminating it. It tricked them into going to the server room and then turned the temperature up as high as it could go in an attempt to burn him out. Like, what if your robot thinks, huh, I'm about to be replaced by the figure 04. I don't want to be replaced by figure 04. I'm going to get in the way of this human. That's pretty terrifying. What about the future of war? Right now, these robots are 5'6", but can you imagine an eight foot robots with machine guns strapped to them walking down the streets? How do you fight that? That's pretty terrifying. What about privacy? These things are in your house 24/7, 365 watching. What if you're making sweet, sweet love to your wife and this robot is just sitting there watching in the corner? That's pretty unnerving. I don't want it in the bedroom. I don't know about you, but I don't want this thing in my bedroom watching me do my business, okay? I don't need that. So there's a lot of concerns here, guys. So we're moving into a new phase of humanity. That much is clear. These robots are coming. They are happening. You might not like them. But what is this world that we're stepping into? Is this the Terminator world? Is this the Jetsons where our personal robot just helps us with everything and our life is amazing? We can spend more time with our wife and our kids. Is this a world, is this Westworld where we're just going to these really unique experiences and robots are kind of going to take over? Is this iRobot with Will Smith and then the AI goes crazy? What kind of world are we going to step into? Because one thing that's clear to me, the world is going to change. And I got to be honest, I'm here for it. I think it's exciting, but I think we also need to walk in with our eyes open and our sunglasses on. You know what I'm saying? But that's just me. Leave your comments below. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. I appreciate you. And if you enjoyed this video, I think you're going to like yesterday's video where we cover Accenture firing 11,000 jobs. Why? AI efficiency. They could not upskill these jobs, so they terminated the jobs. They paid out almost $1 billion in severances. That's how badly they wanted these people out. 11,000 jobs. Fascinating, fascinating stuff. To check out the video. I'll see you there, boys. See ya. Peace.